create three layers and name them Outline, Details, and Color. Let's begin by creating the top of the soda can. With the ellipse tool, create a perfect circle while holding Shift on your keyboard. With the circle selected, hold Shift on your keyboard and rotate it to the right like this. We will then go to the Tools panel and select the Scale tool. Once selected, press Enter on your keyboard under Non-Uniform, input 82% for horizontal and 70.5% for vertical. Next, select the Shear tool. Once again, press Enter on your keyboard, and in this box, input a 30-degree angle. Finally, activate the Rotate tool, press Enter, and input minus 30-degree angle, and confirm by pressing on OK. Now we have created the top shape for the can. Let's now create the inside shape. Select the oval, go to the Object menu at the top, and select Offset Path. I will put a minus 15 pixel offset and press OK to confirm. We will add the inner rim. Hold Option or Alt on your keyboard and duplicate the oval downwards. Since these shapes are overlapping, we will clean these up using the Shape Builder tool. With this tool selected, hold Option or Alt on your keyboard and delete this bottom line by clicking on it. Let's create the bottom of the rim. Duplicate downwards one of the ovals. With the Direct Selection tool, select the top anchor point and delete it. Next, activate the Pen tool and connect the left and the right side to the rim. Using the Direct Selection tool once again, select the bottom anchors and drag them up to match the sketch. Perfect, now repeat this process for the bottom of the can. Alright, now let's create the can opener. Create a rectangle and add two circles in it. Select all and group them together. To create the perfect angle that will go at the top, we will follow the same method that we used earlier to create the top shape. Once completed, match it to the sketch reference. For the overlapping lines, we will clean these up using the Shape Builder once again. Now that we are done the outline, we will add the shapes for the details. On the Details layer, activate the Pen tool and trace out what would be some shadows and other details. Make sure to close off your shapes at the end. Double-click the shape to isolate it. With the Pen tool, if you click on the lines, you can add new anchor points. With the Direct Selection tool, delete the other anchors. And then complete the shape by using the Pen tool. We are now ready to add the base colors to the drawing. Activate the color layer, and with the Pen tool and a color fill, retrace the outline we created. I will leave the color codes in my description. Thank you. Now let's add color to our detailed shapes. This represents some details and some shadows. Finally, we will add some gradients going from light to dark to give the illustration a 3D effect. Now, if you really want to make this can look cool, then you can play with the gradient panel even more by adding some eye-popping colors. Try to stick with the warm colors though. I will sample colors from my Dom Designs color palette for this. And there you have it, everyone. How to create a vector isometric illustration in Adobe Illustrator. Let me know in the comments if you'd like to see more isometric drawing videos in the future. And thanks for watching. Cheers, everyone.